Welcome to our service on the 24th Sunday after Pentecost. We thank Constantine for accompanying the hymns and for the postlude at the end of the service. We ask for God's blessings for the service and for each and every one of you. Let us pray. God, our Father, we thank you for this service. Be with your blessings amongst us when we pray for peace. Let us be instruments of your peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Reading 1 Kings chapter 17 verses 8 to 16. The word of the Lord came to Elijah, saying, "Go now to Zarephath, which belongs to Sidon, and live there, for I have commanded a widow there to feed you." So he set out and went to Zarephath. When he came to the gate of the town, a widow was there gathering sticks. He called to her and said, "Bring me a little water in a vessel so that I may drink." As she was going to bring it, he called to her and said, "Bring me a morsel of bread in your hand." But she said, "As the Lord your God lives, I have nothing baked, only a handful of meal in a jar and a little oil in a jug. I am now gathering a couple of sticks so that I may go home and prepare it for myself and my son, that we may eat it and die." Elijah said to her, "Do not be afraid. Go and do as you have said, but first make me a little cake of it and bring it to me, and afterwards make something for yourself and your son. For thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, the jar of meal will not be emptied, and the jug of oil will not fail until the day that the Lord sends rain on the earth." She went and did as Elijah said, so that she, as well as he and her household, ate for many days. The jar of meal was not emptied, neither did the jug of oil fail, according to the word of the Lord that he spoke by Elijah. Here ends the first reading.
The gospel reading is from Mark chapter 12, verses 41 to 44. Jesus sat down opposite the place where the offerings were put and watched the crowd putting their money into the temple treasury. Many rich people threw in large amounts, but a poor widow came and put in two very small copper coins, worth only a fraction of a penny.
Und Jesus setzte sich dem Gotteskasten gegenüber und sah, wie die Menschen Geld einlegten. Und viele Reiche legten viel ein. Und es kam eine arme Witwe, sie legte zwei Schärflein ein, zwei Geldstücke. Das macht zusammen einen Groschen.
Calling his disciples to him, Jesus said, "I tell you the truth, this poor widow has put more into the treasury than all the others. They all gave out of their wealth, but she, out of her poverty, put in everything, all she had to live on."
Und Jesus rief seine Jünger zu sich und sprach zu ihnen: Wahrlich, ich sage euch, diese arme Witwe hat mehr in den Gotteskasten gelegt als alle, die etwas hineingelegt haben. Denn sie haben alle etwas von ihrem Überfluss eingelegt. Diese aber hat von ihrer Armut ihre letzte Habe eingelegt, alles, was sie zum Leben hatte. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Our text today is the Gospel, Mark 12, verses 41 to 44, and also the reading from the Old Testament. Dear sisters and brothers in Jesus Christ, today we heard two Bible readings about widows who had no rights and belonged to the poorest people at their times. One widow shared her last meal with the prophet Elijah. The other widow gave her last two coins in the offering box at the temple. During today's sermon, we want to reflect about both widows. Let us recall what happened before Elijah met this widow. In the name of God, the prophet Elijah had to predict that there would be no dew or rain for the next 2 or 3 years. It happened because King Ahab sinned against God in worshipping Baal, one of the gods of his wife. He was building him an altar and a temple. The king and many people of Israel prayed to idols and therefore disobeyed the first commandment. After more than 2 years without any rain, everything was used up. The people of Israel suffered, were hungry, thirsty, and exhausted. Even the prophet Elijah had to find another place, because the small stream of water where he got some water dried up. This was one reason why God sent Elijah to this widow. In Zarephat, Elijah met a widow who lived alone with her 6 sons. She was poor and desperate. She knew exactly how little she had and how long it would last, and she was exhausted by the fight for survival. Now there was only food for one more meal, and she was ready to prepare the last meal for herself and her son. Without rain, there was no possibility for seeding, cultivating or harvesting, and therefore for surviving. She saw no alternative for herself and her son. In this dark moment, she was gathering sticks for a fire at the gate when Elijah appeared. She did not know right away that he was God's prophet. For her, he was a stranger, someone whom she never saw before. He asked for water, something very precious after those long years without rain. The widow, however, was willing to share the water. Then Elijah asked for bread. It is understandable that the widow's first reaction was to explain her situation. She told Elijah, "Surely, as the Lord lives, I do not have any bread." Elijah told her not to be afraid and continue what she was planning to do, but first serve him a piece of bread. He promised that the God of Israel will take care of her and that her oil and flour will not run out until the drought has passed. The widow trusted him, even if she did not know anything about him. She would have had many excuses not to share your last bread and eat it just the first son. The widow divided the little she had left. She prepared the food and gave it first to the prophet. The miracle happened. From that moment on, and for as long as necessary, there was enough flour and oil for her, her son, and Elijah. The widow was impressed by Elijah's words about the God of Israel. She shared the very last food she had, and therefore found satisfaction and enough to eat during this hard time. God's prophet lived in the widow's house. Even though this woman had no name, she had a voice. She spoke directly and clearly about her economic situation. She hoped that God's love for her would reveal something unexpected in the midst of her poverty. Therefore, she opened her heart, kneaded the dough, and prepared the bread for Elijah first. In her hopeless situation, she trusted that something new could happen. For many people, God became present through this woman's giving. Today she calls us to share the table, share the bread, and share her story and her destiny. The message of this Bible reading is the invitation to know about our own situation and trust God, even in hopeless and unpromising situations. We should share what we have, open our homes and hearts, invite a stranger, help out and listen to others. This attitude of openness, giving, and sharing can turn our lives around. The sharing of the widow was blessed by God. Our sharing is blessed by God as well. The gospel about the other poor widow stays in connection to the Old Testament reading about the widow of Zarephath. Both gave their very last possessions to God. One shared her food with the prophet, the other one gave her last little money as offering to the temple. God saw what they were doing. Jesus drew the attention of his disciples to this woman. Nobody would have noticed that this poor widow gave her last coins. Normally, the rich people who gave a huge amount of money to the temple were admired and got applause from the people about the temple treasury. When some people gave a huge amount of money, it could have been a small percentage of their possessions. Jesus saw what the woman had compared to what she owned. She gave everything to God, while all the others gave only a part of their possessions. Jesus knew about the widow and honored her in teaching his disciples. Unfortunately, we do not know how she managed her life without money. Certainly, she trusted God in the same way like the widow from the Old Testament and many other people. She expected God to take care of her. Maybe she had some nice neighbors or family members who liked to share with her. We know that God gives his blessings to those who share, and therefore we trust that this widow found help in her time of need. What do we learn from those two widows? God knows what we are doing and in which way we serve others. He also sees the small things we do. He knows where or when we invest time, courage, or money in order to help someone or to change something for the better. Many people do much more than we would imagine. God knows about it, and Jesus points to all those who do something significant in their time and situation, even if nobody is aware of it. Here are questions for all of us. In which way do we generously devote our time, talents, and possessions to others? What can we share with others? What can we donate to make a difference in the lives of people? Many of us already found good and useful ways to support the church or other people with talents, time, and money. Many people pray for one another, take care of one another, and change something for the better. In today's time, it is our task to do what we can for peace, righteousness, and the protection of God's creation. It is not necessary that others see what we do. It is enough that God knows about it. It can be a great experience, and we may feel pleasure and freedom when we give away from our possessions. In this way, we can be open for the essential things. We praise and thank God in giving and serving. We are not captured by the thought that our possessions are the only important things in life. Both of the widows are examples for us. They show us how far sharing and serving can go, and how strong the trust in God can grow. Sometimes it seems easier for poor people to share with others. Today we often experience that people are in the center of attention when they have influence, might, power, and possessions. It is not the right way to follow their goals, which often help rich people to possess even more and take it from the poor people who get less. God looks at each of us from a different perspective. His words and His will never change and continues through different times and circumstances. Sometimes we experience the same like the widow in the Old Testament. We don't know how to continue our way, how to manage the next day. We feel exhausted and without courage and strength. We have problems to cope with our situation, or we feel alone or desperate. God will watch over us and care for tomorrow and for our future. God needs us in our present time, here and now. It is good and essential to be part of His worldwide congregation and work with love and devotion on His kingdom. Day by day, let us ask God where He needs us to share something, bring love, peace, or hope, or change something for the better. We ask for God's blessings, that we understand about His love and mercy, and do what we can to bring the light of God to others and into our world. Together, we want to praise God through everything that we do. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. And the peace of God, which transcends all our understanding, will guard our hearts and minds in Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you.
Wir wollen aufstehen und miteinander und füreinander beten. Please answer with your mercy is great.
We give you thanks for social ministries of the church around the world and for every ministry that heals, lifts up, and empowers those who are poor, oppressed, abused, abandoned, or ignored. Build up your ministries and prosper all works of mercy. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great.
Herr, du gibst uns Mehl und Öl und alles, was wir zum Leben brauchen, durch deine Schöpfung. Lass uns achtsam mit unseren Ressourcen umgehen, sodass auch unsere Kinder und Kindeskinder gut leben können. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great. We praise you for the bounty of creation and a world of abundance. Protect the earth from all who would devour its resources. Create and strengthen sustainable communities who honor your creation with loving care. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Herr, das Leben von uns Menschen ist oft auf uns selbst ausgerichtet. Wir vergessen manchmal, dass es andere gibt außer uns. Gib uns die Kraft, unser Tun zu überdenken und anderen mit der gleichen Liebe zu begegnen, mit der du uns begegnest. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We give you thanks for leaders who seek peace for all nations and lead efforts toward greater justice. Accompany all who suffer the wounds of war, with veterans who carry battle scars from the past, and all who promote peace today. Hear us, O God,
your mercy is great.
Herr, der Tod ist Teil unseres Lebens und lässt uns einsam zurück. Sei bei uns und hilf uns, unsere Einsamkeit zu überwinden. Öffne unsere Augen für alle, die einsam sind, dass wir ihre Bedürfnisse sehen und sie unterstützen. Wir bitten für alle, die krank und allein sind, in unserer Gemeinde und überall. Besonders beten wir für Trudi und Martha, Paulette, Edith und Ursula N. Sei bei uns und unseren Lieben und segne uns alle. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Herr, dreieiniger Gott, du bist mit uns in unserem Gebet. Du bist mit uns in unserem Leben. Dir sei Lob und Ehre in Ewigkeit. Amen. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer in German or English. Vater unser im Himmel, geheiligt werde dein Name, dein Reich komme, dein Wille geschehe, wie im Himmel, so auf Erden. Unser tägliches Brot gib uns heute und vergib uns unsere Schuld, wie auch wir vergeben unseren Schuldigern. Und führe uns nicht in Versuchung, sondern erlöse uns von dem Bösen. Denn dein ist das Reich und die Kraft und die Herrlichkeit in Ewigkeit. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.